Welcome. In today's lecture, we will study this topic, diagonalization of matrices. Our subject code is MA151 and subject name is Mathematics 1. So, we will study diagonalization of matrices. This concept is also associated with square matrices only. Further, we have studied how to find out eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a given square matrix. In diagonalization, we will need to calculate eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a given matrix, and then we will perform the diagonalization process, and then we will get a diagonal matrix corresponding to a given square matrix. So the process of calculating a diagonal matrix equivalent to a given square matrix having same eigenvalues is known as diagonalization. For diagonalization, we require that a square matrix A must have a square matrix A of order n cross n must have n linearly independent eigenvectors. So if we have a matrix of order 3 by 3, then we should be able to get 3 linearly independent eigenvectors in order to have the process of diagonalization. So if a matrix of order n has less than n number of linearly independent eigenvectors, for example, if a matrix of order 3 has 2 or less than 3 eigenvectors, then the diagonalization will not be possible. So diagonalization will be possible only if we can find number of eigenvectors equal to the order of the given square matrix. Now, how will we diagonalize a square matrix? For that, first we need to find eigenvalues of the square matrix. Suppose we have a matrix of order 3. Suppose I consider a matrix of order 3, then we should have 3 linearly independent eigenvectors. Now we need to find eigenvalues. Suppose we calculate eigenvalues which are equal to lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. And then after the calculation of eigenvalues, if we can have equal number of eigenvectors, linearly independent eigenvectors. For example, if I get eigenvectors x, y, and z, and as you know, our eigenvector will be column vectors having 3 elements. So we can have these notations for the eigenvectors. So if we have a 3 by 3 matrix, and if we calculate 3 eigenvalues, and after that if we calculate 3 linearly independent eigenvectors, then we can perform the diagonalization process. To perform the diagonalization process, we need to make a special matrix known as model matrix. We need to construct a model matrix. This model matrix is usually denoted by P, and this model matrix P consists of eigenvectors as columns of the matrix. So for a given square matrix of order 3 by 3 or corresponding model matrix which will be needed for diagonalization, z1, z2, z3. So I am illustrating the process of diagonalization with the help of a 3 by 3 matrix. We can apply same idea for the matrices of square matrices of other orders. For example, 2 by 2 matrices, 4 by 4 matrices, etc. So for a 3 by 3 matrix or model matrix will be like this. So you can see what I have done. I have written all the eigenvectors side by side. So in this way, we have obtained the model matrix for a given square matrix. And now we will see how to diagonalize a given square matrix. To diagonalize a given square matrix, we will use this formula of diagonalization, which says that corresponding to any square matrix, to obtain diagonalization, we can use this formula to get a diagonalized matrix. So if we will calculate the inverse of the model matrix, and if you calculate the product of these three matrices, A is the given square matrix and B is the model matrix, P inverse is the inverse of the model matrix, then we will get a diagonal matrix. And you will also observe that this diagonal matrix, when you will multiply all the three matrices, you will get a diagonal matrix having eigenvalues at the principal diagonal positions. So we will have the eigenvalues at the principal diagonal positions. So this is the way to diagonalize a given square matrix. Now we can see a short proof of obtaining this diagonalized form. Why we get a diagonal matrix D having eigenvalues on the principal diagonal when we calculate P inverse AP? To understand this, for example, in the case of a 3 by 3 square matrix, if you try to calculate the value of AP, where A is a given square matrix of order 3 and P is the model matrix. So you can note down the columns of P. Columns of P are the eigenvectors of the given matrix. Now if you calculate this, and if I, because A is a 3 by 3 matrix having 3 rows and 3 columns, so A has 3 rows. Okay. Now I use different type of notation here. So what I do is that instead of writing this complete column x next to x3, if I write capital X only, so capital X will represent the column. So when you will multiply a matrix A with P, then we will have a matrix having columns equal to A X, second column equal to A Y, third column equal to A Z. Correct? So you can visualize that if A is a 3 by 3 matrix, and if you multiply A with P, then your columns of the resultant matrix will be in this form. Correct? So we will have this. Now after this, we know that X, capital X, capital Y, capital Z are eigenvectors corresponding to lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. So we should have these three relations, that A lambda 1, A capital X is equal to lambda 1 X. Similarly, A capital Y is equal to lambda 2 Y, and A capital Z is equal to lambda 3 Z. So here we will have lambda 1x, here we will have lambda 2x column, and here we will have lambda 2y column, and here we will have lambda 3z column. So in this way we will get a matrix, and we can write this matrix as this. If we separate the x, y, z, if I write x, y, z explicitly as x1, x2, x3, capital X as x1, x2, x3, capital Y as y1, y2, y3, and capital Z as z1, z2, z3, then I can see that this result is actually equal to lambda 1, 0, is actually equal to the product of these two matrices. So, in this way, we observe that AP is equal to PD, where D is our diagonalized matrix. So, we have this relation, AP is equal to PD. Now, pre-multiplying this equation by P inverse, we will get this formula. So, this describes the theory behind the origin of this formula. So, and further, it is a type of similarity transformation. So, two matrices A and D are said to be similar if they have this type of relationship, AP equal to PD. So, this is the theory behind the diagonalization, and you can observe that we have obtained the working rule for performing diagonalization of a given matrix. So, first we will calculate the eigenvalues, then we will calculate the eigenvectors, and then we will calculate the model matrix. And after the calculation of model matrix, we will use this formula to get the diagonalized form of the given square matrix. Next, I take an example, a 2 by 2 matrix, and I perform this working rule on that matrix to have the diagonalization of that square matrix. So I can write the question like this: diagonalize a square matrix A of order 2 by 2, 4, minus 1, 2, 1, so we will try to solve this question. Diagonalize a given square matrix A. How to solve? First we need to calculate eigenvalues. To calculate eigenvalues, we will make the characteristic equation of the given square matrix, and that characteristic equation will be 4 minus lambda minus 1 2 1 minus lambda equal to 0. So after this, we simplify this 2 by 2 determinant to have 4 minus lambda into 1 minus lambda plus 2 equal to 0. Now we multiply these two terms to have 4 minus lambda and minus 4 lambda minus 5 lambda and plus lambda square plus 2 equal to 0. So finally we get lambda square minus 5 lambda plus 6 equal to 0. Now the factorization of 6 minus lambda and minus 4 lambda. So we are getting minus 5 lambda and 4 plus lambda square. So factorization will be 3 into 2. Minus 3 into minus 2. So minus 3 into minus 2 when multiplied gives 6, and when added gives minus 5. So the factorization on left hand side will be lambda minus 3, lambda minus 2 equal to 0. So we will get lambda equal to 2 and 3. So this is the calculation of eigenvalues. Now corresponding to these eigenvalues, we need to find eigenvectors. To calculate eigenvectors, we will use this equation, A minus lambda I x equal to 0, for every we have two eigenvalues. Now we solve this equation for lambda equal to 2. So we will take lambda equal to 2 and we will solve this system of this homogeneous system of linear equation. So we can have a minus 2i x equal to 0. Now suppose x is, because it is a 2 by 2 matrix, so I take x equal to x1 x2, having a column vector having 2 elements only. And in place of lambda we are taking 2, so this a minus 2i matrix will be like this. 4 minus 2, 2, minus 1, and then 2, then 1 minus 2, minus 1. So this is a minus 2i matrix. X vector is x1, x2, and on the right you will have a 0 vector. So you can see this is the homogeneous system of linear equation, and we want to solve it to have non-zero values of x1, x2. So if you observe, we are getting only one equation, 2x1 minus x2 equal to 0. And this one equation can be solved by taking x2 equal to k, an arbitrary constant, then x1 will be equal to k by 2. So our eigenvector will be equal to k by 2 k. Or equivalently, our eigenvector will be k half 1, or equivalently we can have eigenvector half 1, or more conveniently we can write 1, 2. So you know this fact that any constant multiple of an eigenvector is again the same kind of eigenvector for corresponding to same eigenvalue and the given matrix. So our eigenvector is 1, 2 corresponding to the eigenvalue 2. So I write here, so our eigenvector is 1. Now I calculate eigenvector for lambda equal to 3. So to calculate eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 3, I need to write 3 here, and you can go with the same notation, because ultimately we need to find the value of x1 x2. So the numerical value which we will get will be of use only. And if you want, you can use different notation. You can take capital Y, Y1, Y2, and here you can take capital Y. But ultimately we need this numerical value of the eigenvector. So we can go with the same notation. Now our system will change. So when we will take lambda equal to 3, then here we will have 1, here minus 1, 2, and here we will have minus 2. So we will, this time we will get only, this time also we will get one equation only. So our one equation will be x1 minus x2 equal to 0. Now if we assume x2 equal to k, then x1 will also be equal to k. So equivalently our eigenvector will be 1, 1. So the eigenvector corresponding to 3 is 1, 1. Now we perform diagonalization. So for diagonalization, we will use this formula, P inverse AP. And for this we need P, as we have studied how to calculate the model matrix P. To find this model matrix P, we will write the eigenvectors side by side. So our model matrix will be 1, 2, 1, 1. So you can note down, to construct model matrix what I have done, I have written the column, the eigenvectors side by side. So this 2 by 2 matrix is the model matrix. Now for diagonalization you will need inverse and we have a short trick to calculate inverse of 2 by 2 matrix, and that is to interchange the principal diagonal element and negate the opposite diagonal elements and divide it by the determinant. So the determinant will be equal to 1 minus 2. So this will be minus 1 will be the determinant. So ultimately P inverse will be, so we need to multiply minus 1 to all the elements. So we will get minus 1, plus 1, 2 and minus 1. So you can see this is our P inverse. Now to have diagonal matrix, we need to calculate P inverse AP. So we calculate P inverse AP. So this is our P inverse and this is our A, original matrix. Original matrix is 4, minus 1, 2, 1. Original matrix is 4, minus 1, 2, 1. And then the P, border matrix is 1, 1, 2, 1. Next, we multiply. So while multiplying, you can use the property of the matrix multiplication, that matrix multiplication is not commutative. So do not multiply this first matrix with the third matrix directly, because matrix multiplication is not commutative. So either you can first multiply first and second matrix, or first you can multiply second and third matrix. So for example here, if I keep first matrix as such, and if I multiply second and third matrix, then what will be the result? The result will be 4 minus 2. 2, 4 minus 1, 3, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 1, 3. So I have multiplied second and third matrix and obtained this matrix 2, 3, 4, 3. Now I multiply these two matrices. So I will get minus 2, 4. So minus 2 and 4 I get 2, minus 3 and 3 I get 0, 4 and minus 4 I get 0, 6 and minus 3, so I get 3 here. So you can observe I have obtained a diagonal matrix. So this is what we say diagonalization of a given square matrix. So in this way, I have diagonalized the given square matrix by calculating the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors, and then constructing the model matrix and calculating its inverse, and then using this formula to have the diagonal matrix. And you can observe that in the diagonal matrix, on the principal diagonal, I am getting eigenvalues which I calculated previously, and further, if you will change the order of the eigenvector while constructing model matrix. So here I took 1, 2 as the first and 1, 1 as the second vector. Now if someone select 1, 1 as the first vector and 1, 2 as the second vector, in that case this diagonalization process will be successful, and here you will get eigenvalue 3 at 1, 1 position and eigenvalue 2 at 2, 2 position. So this 2 eigenvalue here corresponds to 1, 2 eigenvector, and this 3 eigenvalue corresponds to 1, 1 eigenvector. So while constructing model matrix, you can change the order of the eigenvector. That will not affect the process of diagonalization. So it was an example of diagonalization with 2 by 2 matrix. Next I will consider a 3 by 3 matrix. So in the next question, I write a 3 by 3 matrix. This 3 by 3 matrix is, suppose it is given like this, minus 2, 2, minus 3, 2, 1, minus 6, minus 1, minus 2, 0. So this is the given square matrix, 3 by 3 square matrix. Now the question is, to diagonalize the given square matrix A. How to diagonalize? First we need to calculate eigenvalues. So first we find eigenvalues. Now to find eigenvalues, we have an, you know this equation, that you need to solve this characteristic equation to get the eigenvalues. Alternatively, for a 3 by 3 matrix, we have this idea, lambda cube minus s1 lambda square plus s2 lambda minus s3 equal to 0. So, using this equation, we can construct the characteristic equation directly for a given square matrix, for a given 3 by 3 square matrix only. So, this trick is applicable only for 3 by 3 square matrix. So, because the given matrix is a 3 by 3 matrix, so to find eigenvalues, first we want to calculate the eigenvalue equation, and the eigenvalue equation will be equal to this equation, where S1 is the sum of the diagonal element. So the sum of the diagonal element is minus 1. So S1 is minus 1. And S2 is the sum of the minus of the main diagonal element. So S2 is sum of these 2 by 2 determinants plus the minor of 1 will be minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, 0, and the minor of 0 will be minus 2, 2, 2, 1. So you can observe what I have done for the calculation of S2. For the calculation of S2, I am calculating the sum of the minus of minus 2, 1 and 0. So the 1 minus 6, minus 2, 0 is a minor of this minus 2 element, and minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, 0 is a minor of 1, and minus 2, 2, 2, 1 is a minor of this last diagonal element 0. So now we calculate these 2 by 2 determinants. So we get 1 minus 12. So we get minus 11. Then 0 minus 3, so we get minus 3. Then minus 2 minus 4, so we get minus 6. So ultimately we get minus 9 and minus 11, so we get minus 20. So our S2 is equal to minus 20 here. Next we calculate S3. So S3 will be the determinant of A. So you know the short trick to find the value of the determinant of A. So we follow that trick. So for that we need to multiply these three principal diagonal elements. So we get 0. Then we need to multiply 2 minus 6 minus 1. So we get 12, and then we need to multiply 2 minus 2 and 3, so we get 12 with plus sign. Next we multiply the opposite diagonal elements, so we get plus 3 opposite diagonal elements. Then we multiply these three elements, minus 2, minus 2, minus 6, so the sign will be minus, and we will get 6 into 4, 24. And then we will multiply 2 to 0, so we will get the 0. Now we can simplify it. So 24 minus 20, 24 minus 3 plus 24. So 48 minus 3 is equal to 45. So in this way we have obtained S3 equal to 45. Now, before proceeding, we can verify these values because we have performed numerical calculations. So, S1, the calculation of S1 was minus 1 and the S2 gave us. So, here you can observe that we will have 0, so we will have minus 12. So, we will have minus 21. So, the value of S2 is minus 21 and the value of S3 is 45 and the value of S1 is minus 1. So, our characteristic equation will be lambda cube minus S1 means we will have plus lambda square here because S1 is minus 1, S2 is minus 21. So, we will have minus 21 lambda here. Further, S3 is 45. So, we will have minus 45 here. So, this is our characteristic equation. Now, we need to solve this characteristic equation. To solve this characteristic equation, this cubic equation, we apply heat and trial method, and for that you can select value of lambda which satisfies this equation. So if you select lambda equal to 0, lambda equal to 0 does not satisfy. If you select lambda equal to 1, lambda equal to 1 does not satisfy. If you select lambda equal to 2, lambda equal to 2 also does not satisfy in this equation. When you will select lambda equal to 3, then you will observe that for lambda equal to 3, lambda cube will be equal to 27, lambda square will be equal to 9, and here we will have 21 into 3, so we will have minus 63 and minus 45. So, lambda equal to 3 also does not satisfy the given equation. So, we try lambda equal to minus 3. Now, when lambda will be equal to minus 3, then here we will have minus 27, and here we will have 9, and here we will have plus 63, and here we will have minus 45. So, here we have minus 27. Okay. Now, if you sum, so you will get 9 plus 63. So, you get 72. And if you add this, you will get minus 7 and 5, 12. And then 72. So, you will get 0. So, you observe that for lambda equal to minus 3, this characteristic equation is satisfied. So, lambda equal to minus 3 is a root. So, you can write that lambda equal to minus 3 is a root. Or lambda plus 3, or lambda plus 3 is a factor of the left hand side cubic expression. So, we can divide the left hand side cubic expression by lambda plus 3 to have a factorization of left hand side in the form of a linear factor and a quadratic factor. Alternatively, we can calculate the coefficient of that that quadratic factor, the second factor, which we will obtain if we divide lambda plus 3. If we divide this cubic expression by lambda plus 3, we will get a quadratic expression. So, we can obtain the coefficient of that quadratic factor alternatively by applying a synthetic division procedure. So, what I do is, I apply synthetic division. So, with the help of this synthetic division, we will be able to factorize this left hand side cubic expression. So, how to proceed in synthetic division? We have this procedure. because minus 3 is a root, so we start with minus 3 and we write all the coefficients of the cubic expression in decreasing order. So the highest power coefficient is 1, then 1, then minus 21, and then minus 45. And for synthetic division, by default we select a 0 here, and after this we multiply these two numbers by minus 3 and add the results. So minus 3 into 1, minus 3, minus 3 into 0, 0, minus 3 and 0, minus 3. Next, the same type of calculation, multiply minus 3 with 1, minus 3, multiply minus 3 with minus 3, plus 9, so 9 minus 3 is equal to 6. So you can note down this way of calculation. What I am doing here is, I am multiplying minus 3 with 1, minus 3, I am multiplying minus 3 with minus 3, plus 9, so plus 9 and minus 3 becomes 6, so I am writing 6 here. Now, I will repeat this type of calculation up to n. So the I can calculate the number which I should write here in this way, multiply minus 3 with minus 21, so we will get 63, plus 63, and multiply minus 3 with 6, so then we will get minus 18. Now plus 63 minus 18 will give us plus 45. Okay, so what I am doing here is, I am multiplying minus 3 with minus 21, so I am getting plus 63, minus 3 with 6, so I am getting minus 18. Now plus 63 minus 18 gives me plus 45, so I am writing this plus 45 here. After this, we will add all the pairs. So here I have 1, here I have minus 2, and minus 21 minus 6, I have minus 15, and here I have 0. So this part gives me the coefficient of the quadratic expression, which will be obtained by dividing this cubic expression by lambda plus 3. So according to synthetic division, the factorization of left hand side will be, because minus 3 is a root, so lambda plus 3 is one factor, and the quadratic factor will have coefficients from these three positions. So our quadratic expression will be lambda square minus 2 lambda minus 15 equal to 0. So this is the factorization of this cubic expression. Now after factorization, we need to simplify this quadratic expression. So here you can observe that a factorization of minus 15 in the form of minus 5 into plus 3, when these two numbers multiply, will give us minus 15, and when we will add, we will get minus 2. So the factorization will be lambda plus 3, lambda minus 5, lambda plus 3 equal to 0. So the eigen values will be equal to minus 3, minus 3, and 5. So what I am doing is, I am writing these eigen values here. I am writing these eigen minus 3, minus 3 simultaneously to indicate that we are getting two repeated eigen values. We are getting same eigen values. Correct? Now, after the calculation of eigen values, we will go to find eigen vectors. So, how to find eigen vectors corresponding to all the eigen values? So, to find eigen vectors, we will solve this system, this homogeneous system of equations. So for lambda equal to 5, so for lambda equal to 5, if we want to calculate eigenvector, then we need to solve this system, a minus 5i x equal to 0. Or so the coefficient matrix of this homogeneous system will have these entries. So I will subtract minus 5 from the principal diagonal element of the given square matrix A. So I will have minus 7, 2, minus 3, 2, 1 minus 5, minus 4, minus 6, minus 1, minus 2, 0 minus 5 is minus 5. So what I am doing is I am writing a minus 5 by only. So that if x is an eigenvector equal to x1, x2, x3, then I can calculate the values of x1, x2, x3 by the short trick explained previously. So with this idea, what we will do, we will note the coefficient matrix of this homogeneous system from which we want to calculate our eigenvector, and then we will get the entries of the eigenvectors from this relation. So below x1, now we need to select any two rows of this system which are not identical and which are not the constant multiple of each other. So we can select the second and third row also. Now if we select, we can also select first and second in this case, because all the three rows are different. Okay, so we are selecting second and third row because the entries are simpler in these two rows. So below x1 we will have a 2 by 2 determinant equal to minus 4, minus 6, minus 2, minus 5. And below x2, so we should have minus sign with x2 here. Below x2, we will have a determinant 2, minus 6, minus 1, minus 5. Okay. So if you will not write minus sign here, then you need to remember to write minus sign here with this 2 by 2 determinant, which have been obtained by deleting the second column in the set of these two rows, which we have selected for the calculation of or eigenvectors. Now below x3 we will have 2, minus 4, minus 1, minus 2. Now we can solve these 2 by 2 determinants. So we will have plus 20, minus plus 12. So 20 minus 12 we will have 8. And here we will have minus 10 and minus 6. So minus 10 and minus 6 will give me minus 16. And because of this minus sign, I will have plus 16 here. And here I will have minus 4 and then minus plus 4. So minus 4 and minus plus 4 means I will have minus 8 here. So you can observe, we will have minus 8 here and 8 below x1 and 16 below x2. So our eigenvector will be 8, 16 and minus 8. So alternatively we can simplify 8 and we can write it like this, 1, 2, minus 1. So the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue 5 is, eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue 5 is 1, 2, minus 1. Now we calculate eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalues minus 3. So what we do, we note down the eigenvalues and eigenvectors on the right, because we will be using these eigenvectors to construct our model matrix P. So our eigenvalues are 5, minus 3, minus 3, and the calculated eigenvector for 5 is 1, 2, minus 1. Now next we calculate eigenvectors for minus 3. Now here you can observe that we have repeated eigenvalues. We have two eigenvalues having value lambda equal to minus 3. So in these types of situation we may get two linearly independent eigenvectors, or in some cases we may not get two linearly independent eigenvectors. So in those cases we may have only one eigenvector. corresponding to the two repeated eigenvalues. So in those cases, the diagonalization will not be possible. So let us see whether diagonalization will be possible or not by calculating the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equal to minus 3. So if we get two linearly independent eigenvectors, two different eigenvectors for one eigenvalue lambda equal to minus 3, then the diagonalization will be possible in this case. And if we will have, if we will get only one eigenvector corresponding to these repeated eigenvalues minus 3, then the diagonalization will not be possible. So let us proceed. So this time we are taking lambda equal to minus 3. So the homogeneous system will have a coefficient matrix of this form, minus 2 minus minus 2 plus 3. So we will have 1 here, then 2 minus 3 here, and 2, 1 plus 3, so 4 minus 6, minus 1 minus 2, and plus 3 here. So we will get this coefficient matrix A minus lambda I for the homogeneous system of linear equation from which we want to calculate the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda equal to minus 3. So you can observe that all the three rows are constant multiple of each other. So ultimately we are getting only one equation from the homogeneous system having this coefficient matrix. So because if you multiply first row by 2, then you will get the second row. Further, if you multiply first row by minus 1, then you will get the third row. So all these three rows are constant multiple of each other. So ultimately we will get only one equation. So if I denote my eigenvector by x1, x2, x3 again, then I will have this equation, x1 plus 2x2 minus 3x3 equal to 0. So from this one equation, to obtain non-zero solution, non-zero solutions of the homogeneous system, we need to consider two arbitrary, we need to consider two variables equal to arbitrary constant. So we assume, because we have only one equation and there are three variables, so we need to consider two variables equal to the arbitrary constant. So if you assume x2 equal to k1 and if you assume x3 equal to k2, then your x1 will be equal to 2k1 minus 3k2 minus 2k1. So the value of x1 will be 3k2 minus 2k1 if we select x2 equal to k1 and x3 equal to k2. Next, so we have actually obtained this eigenvector, 3k2 minus 2k1, k1 and k2. But from this one eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to minus 3, we can calculate two different linearly independent eigenvectors by following this idea. First, select k1 equal to 0 and k2 equal to 1, and then select k1 equal to 1 and k2 equal to 0. So you will have eigenvectors, we will have two different linearly independent eigenvectors corresponding to the repeated eigenvalue minus 3. So if we take k1 equal to 0 and k2 equal to 1, then here we will have 3, k1 is 0 and k2 is 1. So our eigenvector is 3, 0, 1 this time, and corresponding to k1 equal to 1 and k2 equal to 0, our eigenvector will be, because k1 is 1, so minus 2, k1 is 1 and k2 is 0. So our eigenvector will be minus 2, 1, 0. So we can observe that these two eigenvectors are different and they are not the constant multiple of each other. And in this way, we have obtained three different eigenvectors. So I note down these eigenvectors corresponding to the given eigenvalues. So I write minus, for minus 3 I have eigenvector 3, 0, 1, and for the second I have eigenvector minus 2, 1, 0. So let us check 3. Okay. So these are our eigenvectors. Now with the help of these eigenvectors we will be able to diagonalize the given square matrix A by using the previously studied formula. So to diagonalize, first we need to construct the model matrix P. So your P will be 1, 2, minus 1, 3, 0, 1, minus 2, 1, 0. Correct? Next. So we are taking eigenvectors in this order. So when we will diagonalize, we will get 5, minus 3, minus 3 on the principal diagonal of the diagonalized matrix. After the calculation of P, you can calculate P inverse by applying this formula: adjoint of the matrix A upon determinant A. Or you can use Gauss-Jordan method to find the inverse of a given square matrix. After the calculation of P inverse, we will apply this formula: P inverse AP, and then we will get a diagonal matrix D which will have 5, minus 3, minus 3 on the principal diagonal. So in this way you can perform diagonalization. So we have studied in the review of matrices how to calculate P inverse by this formula, adjoint A upon determinant A, and how to find the product of these matrices P inverse A and P. So when you will perform this multiplication, you will get D having 5 minus 3 minus 3 on the principal diagonal. Next, we want to cover a topic of Kelly-Hamilton theorem in this lecture. So we will go through this topic, Kelly-Hamilton theorem. So we have studied diagonalization of the matrices. Now we start Kelly-Hamilton theorem. So in this Kelly-Hamilton theorem, we will be using the calculation of characteristic equation. So you look at the statement of the Kelly-Hamilton theorem. The statement of the Kelly-Hamilton theorem is like this: that every square matrix, satisfies its own characteristic equation. So this is the statement of the Kelly-Hamilton theorem.